I'm not sure what your plans are for Friday, but make sure you're on the couch, dialed into this one, or at least DVR it. Our NHL Tonight special, Analytics Friday, coming up at 6 o'clock Eastern Time right here on NHL Network. Myself, Brian Lawton, Mike Kelly, going to be on hand, and some of the stuff we'll be talking about, the next big trend in hockey, the curious case of Patrick Laine, and which Hughes brother could win the Calder. Interesting stuff. Speaking of Mike Kelly, he's here with us right now doing a segment called Sneaky Skills.
Yes, sir.
I like that. So I tee up a player, what maybe we see from a fan's perspective, and you're going to tell us what we're not really seeing that impresses you about this guy, right?
Exactly. Okay. And, you know, some of these guys, superstars in the National Hockey League, we all know how good they are, but elements of their game where they may be among the best in the league, and certainly maybe not the primary thing that you focus on when you hear this player's name,
yep.
But we're going to show you just how sneaky good these players are in that area.
All right, Patrick Kane. I think of Patrick Kane, I just think of the all hands, incredible hands. What aren't I seeing then?
Well, it's his shot that's elite and among the best in the league. And when you talk about guys with elite shots in the National Hockey League, you're thinking Stammer, you're thinking Ovi, you're thinking Pettersson, these big one-timers, Patrick Laine. Patrick Kane has scored at distance at as good a rate as any player in the NHL. And it's not the overpowering shot with Patrick Kane. It's the pinpoint accuracy, and it's the release, the hand-eye coordination. He is so gifted, and he can score from a number of different areas on the ice. So I talk often about that inner slot, high danger mm-hmm. net front area. The outer slot, the high slot, a little farther out, a little tougher to score. This surprised me. At 5-on-5 in the last three seasons, it's Kane that has scored the most goals from that area, which is right around the faceoff dots, where you've got a little bit of distance to the goaltender and you have to find a way to beat him. Kane scored more than everyone in the National Hockey League. Laine, Ovechkin, Stamkos, all those guys. So with Patrick Kane, we know he's a superstar. You think playmaker when you think about him. You think those silky mitts.
Right.
He's got a weapon of a shot, too, though.
Incredible, and you have the stats to back it up. How about Leon Draisaitl? 50 goals last year, so I think goal scorer. What aren't I seeing?
Let's go the opposite here with Leon Draisaitl. We're talking about one of the best passers in the National Hockey League. A phenomenal playmaker. And if you talk to Leon, he'll tell you the best part about his game is his passing ability. Obviously, playing with Connor McDavid, it helps the fact that you can sauce these passes over and let them go to the net with speed. But look at that backhand sauce.
Incredible.
Incredible touch, incredible vision. Leon Draisaitl, 50-goal scorer in the National Hockey League. So we know he can put the puck in the net. But like I said, one of the best passers. Let's look at some of those passing statistics. Top 15 in assists. Completing passes in the offensive zone, he's top 10. Getting passes into that high-danger slot area. Kucherov was number one in the league. He had the most assists of anybody. There's Leon, top three. And then his pass completion percentage, he completes over 70% of his passes. Also very good as well. So, again, you can talk about Leon Draisaitl as this great goal scorer, which he is, but he's got a real delicate touch, and he knows how to get pucks into those high-danger areas.
All right, we're going to Motown right now. Andreas Athanasiou. Andreas Athanasiou later because of the wheels, right? This guy's got rockets.
You stole my line.
Oh, no.
We didn't even talk about this before,
didn't.
But
is
you
that...
stole my line. But
okay.
I'm going to go with the Motor City then, and this guy's got a big-time motor. Andreas Athanasiou. You know, McDavid again, McKinnon, Pat Kane, all guys that create off the rush. Dylan Larkin's probably the speed threat when you think about Detroit. Andreas Athanasiou has incredible north-south speed. And there's a lot of guys that can skate fast. There's a lot of guys in the American League that can skate fast. What separates guys like McDavid, and I'm not putting Athanasiou in the same category as McDavid, but they can finish as well. How do we quantify speed in the National Hockey League? Not just speed, but being a threat with that speed. Scoring chances off the rush. McKinnon was one, McDavid was two, Athanasiou was number three. He started to score a little bit more with his chances off the rush, and that's why he was a first-time 30-goal scorer in the NHL last season. As he continues to develop his scoring touch and he continues to get those kind of opportunities in that volume, 30 could be a floor for him. He could be a guy that starts pushing up from 30 goals. So, you know, the Red Wings, spoiler alert, they're not going to make the playoffs this coming season. That's my take on it.
Yeah.
This team is worth the price of admission if you're in Detroit because you can go and see Dylan Larkin and you can go and see this guy.
I want to see McDavid, Athanasiou, and a fastest skater. You could throw Larkin in there, too, head-to-head and see how that all plays out.
Totally.
Next guy, John Tavares. I think of him, I think, facilitator, playmaker. Yeah. What else is he?
He's emerged to me as the best net presence in the National Hockey League. And I know this was a big question with the Toronto Maple Leafs coming into this season, especially on the power play where he was going to take James Van Riemsdyk's spot. can he be that lethal net front guy? We saw it a little bit on the island, but of course Anders Lee is really that guy in New York. But John Tavares outperformed everybody in that high danger inner slot area that I talk about this year in all of the meaningful ways that you can look to quantify it. So let's take a look at his shots on goal from that most high danger scoring area on the ice. 139, but he's about 30% more than anyone else in the NHL. There's a big gap between him and number two, Bo Horvat, and you see a lot of real good net front players here. So he had more shots than anybody from this net front area. He had more goals than anybody from this area. Even strength, he can do it. Power play, he can obviously do it as well. John Tavares, to me right now, is the best net player in the National Hockey League.
All right, we've talked a lot about forwards. Let's go to the back end right now. We got to evenly distribute here. Defenseman Nick Hjalmarsson, what's his sneaky skill?
It's not that sneaky, but I feel like we never talk about this guy enough. When we talk about the great defenseman in the league, his sneaky skill, something that's been tough to quantify with traditional statistics, his defensive impact on the game. He will likely go down as the best defensive defenseman of his generation, but you never see him on the lists of top, you know, 10, 20, 30, 40, whatever defenseman. He doesn't have a huge offensive upside. There is value in being good defensively. And you take a look at the amount of shots he blocked last season. You take a look at the amount of passes he blocked in his own end and even strength, getting his stick in passing lanes. And the expected goals against while he's on the ice was seventh lowest of any defenseman in the National Hockey League that play meaningful minutes and that play against tough competition. So, you know, you talk about the Chicago Blackhawks and the Stanley Cup success they enjoyed when Nick Hjalmarsson was there and what they've been missing since he's been gone, especially last season, an incredibly leaky defensive team. Ask the guys that played with Nick Hjalmarsson what his value is. Sneaky defensively, not really, but he's a sneaky top-end defenseman because of how good he is in that way.
How come you think we don't talk about him enough? Because when you think, like, lockdown defenseman, it's always Vlasic in San Jose. But why doesn't Hjalmarsson kind of get the same notoriety? Just where he plays?
Maybe now because he's in Arizona. It's a good point. And, you know, as Arizona improves, you know, maybe you'll hear more talk about Nick Hjalmarsson. But, again, when you talk about defensemen, who comes to mind? Burns and Hedman. And some of these guys are very good defensively in their own right. This is a guy who, in this one facet of the game, happens to be, in my opinion, the best. It's an important facet. Why don't we talk about it enough? It's a tough one to quantify, but because of some of the numbers that we use here and we'll be using on our analytics show, there's ways to kind of look past that and see his real value.
All right, goaltending. Carey Price can stop the puck with the best of them in the world at times. What else? What's his sneaky skill?
I live in Montreal. I started going to Montreal Canadiens games over the last couple years since I moved there. One thing I noticed about Carey Price, this guy can play the puck with the best of them in the NHL. He might be the best puck-handling goalie in the National Hockey League. And there's a lot of value in this. Again, just ask defensemen who have played with good puck-moving goalies. Ask defensemen that have played with poor puck-moving goalies. They'll tell you the value here. To me, right now, if he's not the best puck-handling goalie in the league, he's definitely one of them. How do we quantify that? Let's take a look at the outlet passes Carey Price made. So these are passes getting it to your defensemen so they can start a breakout. This past season, he attempted more than anyone. He completed more than anyone. And his completion rate was the best in the NHL. So not only does he do this a ton, which alleviates a lot of the pressure on their Habs defensemen to go back and get the puck and have to start from farther in their own defensive zone, he does it a ton, but he completes a ton of these passes. And you look at Montreal, really good 5-on-5 team this past season. Their power play absolutely sunk them. Yeah. But at 5-on-5, they play with a lot of pace. Being able to get the puck up quickly to your defensemen and have them go, 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 it's a big part of their attack. Carey Price is a big reason. So we know he can stop the puck.
Yeah.
He can move it too.
And that was a surprise because you think like Mike Smith, you think Ben Bishop, Carey Price first in all those categories.
They
last
were
season.
Right up there too, but that's number one. That's why it's a sneaky skill.
See, that's why we bring you in for all the sneakiness. And you're going to hang around until Friday for that analytics show?
Yes, sir.